हेलो फ्रेंड्स, यू आर वेलकम टू द माय यूट्यूब चैनल मैक पीएम। सो टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर टॉपिक बेंडिंग स्ट्रेसेस इन बीम्स। सो आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज कंपोजिट बीम्स। सो वी विल स्टडी द बेंडिंग स्ट्रेसेस इन कंपोजिट बीम्स। सो व्हाट आर द कंपोजिट बीम्स? ए बीम मेड अप ऑफ टू आर मोर डिफरेंट इन मटेरियल्स एज्यूम्ड टू बी रिजिडली कनेक्टेड टुगेदर एंड बिहेविंग लाइक ए सिंगल पीस नोन एज कंपोजिट बीम और वुडन फ्लिश्ड बीम। सो सपोज दिस इज अ बीम, it has a cross section like this. This is wood and this is steel plates. These steel plates are connected to make this wood stronger. So you can ask that why not use whole steel? So steel is costlier than wood. So we use wood and to make it stronger we use steel plates. So we connect these three beams and make it a single beam. So this type of beam is called composite beam or flashed beam. So what is the property of this beam? So basic thing we have to remember that the moment of resistance due to these two beams will be equal to total moment of resistance. So m is equal to m1, suppose this is 1 and this is 2, so m is equal to m1 plus m2, and strain produced due to bending stress at this contact point will be same for this wood and this steel. So what is the strain? Strain is equal to sigma means stress divided by modulus of elasticity. So sigma 1 upon E1 is equal to sigma 2 upon E2. We have to remember these two equations. By remembering these two, we can solve this question. So what? Let's read this question. This question is: a flashed beam consists of a wooden joist 10 cm wide and 20 cm deep. This is 10 cm wide, 20 cm deep, and strengthened by two steel plates 10 mm thick. So this is 10 mm means 1 cm thick and 20 cm deep, as shown in figure. If the maximum stress in the wooden joist is 7 Newton per mm square. So it is given that sigma wood is 7 Newton per mm square. Find the corresponding maximum stress attained in the steel. So let's solve up to here. So we have seen that strain will be equal, means sigma by E1, sigma 1 by E1 is equal to sigma 2 by E2. So let's see, sigma wood by E wood is equal to sigma steel divided by E steel. So you can see here that sigma wood is 7 and EW is E wood, Young's modulus of elasticity of wood is 10 to the power 4 Newton per mm square. So it is 10 to the power 4 and is equal to sigma steel divided by, this is 2 into 10 to the power 5. So sigma steel will become 7 into 2 into 10 to the power 5 divided by 10 to the power 4. So we will get 140. So sigma steel will be, stress in the steel will be 140 Newton per mm square. So first part is already solved. Now what is the second part? Find the corresponding maximum stress attained in the steel. So m upon I is equal to sigma upon y. So m is equal to sigma I upon y. So we have to calculate I first. So from the diagram you can see that I wood is equal to b h cube by 12. So b is, width is 10, into h is 10 and h is 20 cube divided by 12. So it will become 1333.33 centimeter to power 4, or we can get, sorry, it will be 6666.66 centimeter to the power 4, or we can write it as 6666.66 into 10 to the power 4 mm to the power 4. Now we will calculate I for the moment of inertia of the steel part. So I2 is equal to, we have two similar steel parts, this one and this one. So 2 into बी एच टू द पावर बी एच क्यू टू द पावर 12 बी एच क्यू डिवाइड बाई 12 सो इट इज बी इज 1 सेंटीमीटर 1 इंटू एच इज 20 क्यू डिवाइडेड बाई 12 सो वी विल गेट 1.33 सेंटीमीटर टू द पावर 4 और वी कैन राइट इट एज 1.33 इंटू 10 टू द पावर 4 mm टू द पावर 4 Now, for steel, M is equal to sigma I upon Y, which is M is equal to sigma I upon Y. So, for a steel plate, we have sigma is 140. We have calculated 140, and I is for steel. I is 133.33. Into 10 to the power 4 divided by y is 20 divided by 2 this depth so it is 10 centimeter so we will multiply it with 10 it is 100 mm so if you will calculate this then you will find m1 is equal to 18666.62 newton meter and now for wood we will get m is equal to sigma I upon Y so sigma is 7 newton per mm square it is given in the question and I is for wood I is we have calculated this 6.66 into 10 to the power 4 divided by Y is 10 into 10 so 100 mm so it will become 0.66 newton meter so m is equal to total m moment of resistance of the beam will be m1 plus m2 so we will add this and this so we will get 2.282 newton meter so this is our answer I hope you understand this problem. If you have any doubt, then please ask in the comment section. And if you like this video, then please share and subscribe. Thanks for watching this video.